To the sun and moon, hello! International State College of the Philippines!
K-12 basic education program uses a standards and competency-based grading system. When we say grading system, we mean a system that educators uses in a particular institution to evaluate each individual student's performance and learning. Grading can include letter grades, percentage, and even a simple pass or fail. Grades can be attached to physical activities like writing assignments, lab work, projects, reports, and tests. In Depth Ed, all grades are based on the weighted raw scores of the learner's summative assessment. This summative assessment can be classified into three components, namely written works, performance tasks, and quarterly assessment. These three will be the basis for grading. The nature of the learning area defines the way these three components are assessed. For kindergarten, checklists and anecdotal records are used instead of numerical grades. These are based on learning standards found in the kindergarten curriculum guide. For grades 1 to 2, numerical grades are used. The minimum grade to pass a specific learner's area is 60, which is transmuted to 75 in the report card. The lowest rank mark that can appear on the report card is 60 for quarterly grades and final grades. Teachers in the basic education implementing the K-12 program uses electronic class records in Excel format to facilitate high level of accuracy in the computation of the learner's grade. Each learning has its specific e-class record. Aside from this, different DepEd forms are accomplished at varied time within a school year. In this activity, we are exposed to various DepEd forms and e-class records. We are given opportunities to examine and accomplish different forms, compute quarterly grades and final grades, and accomplish e-class records aligned with our specialization.
The different school forms are necessary to collect vital information about students, their academic progress, and their overall well-being. This information is used by school administrators, teachers, counselors, and other staff members to craft individualized educational plans and provide tailored services to meet the needs of each student. If the school forms are not completed on the specified schedule, it could result in the student being unable to participate in various school activities or being unable to start the new academic year. It could also result in administrative delays, which could cause further problems for the student and their family.
And level of proficiency is a list of the learner's academic performance and result of assessment by the end of the semester.
The SF6 is the summary report on promotion. It contains number of promoted or retained by grade level or the summary of SF5. SF7 is the inventory of a school personnel. It carry out list of school personnel with basic profile and teaching load assignment. The SF8, this is the learner basic health and nutrition profile. It includes per learner assessment of body mass index. SF9 is the learner progress report card. It holds individual academic, behavioral, and attendance report by quarter or formerly called Form 138. The last is the school form number 10. This is the learner's permanent academic record. It contains individual academic record or quarter in school year. It simplifies and standardizes from former Form 137.
What is the DEP Ed Order number 8, school year 2015? This is the policy or guidelines on a classroom assessment for the K-12 basic education program. This is an ongoing process of identifying, gathering, organizing, and interpreting quantitative and qualitative information about what learners know and can do. What are the bases for the grading system in DEP Ed Order number 8, school year 2015? So there is a corresponding components or a weight in every subject for grade 1 to 10 and senior high school. So that components of a summative assessment classified into three, namely the written words, the performance task, and the quarterly assessment. Okay, so let's have the table. So below on the table has a weight are the components for the grade 1 to 10 and senior high school under the DEP Ed number 8 school year 2015. Okay, so on the table, there is a two column which has in a column 1, there is an assessment and a components which is classified into three, the written works, the performance tasks, and the quarterly assessment. On the second column, there is a different subject wherein in English, Araling Palipunan, and ESP or Edukasyon sa Pagpapakatao subject. The written works has a percentage of 30%, the performance task has a percentage of 50%, and the quarterly assessment has a percentage of 20%. On the other side, in science, mathematics subject, the written works has a percentage of 40%, the performance task has a percentage of 40%, and the quarterly assessment has a percentage of 20%. In MAPE and EPP and TLE, the written works has a percentage of 20%, the performance task has a percentage of 60%, and the quarterly assessment has a percentage of 20%. So as you can see, this is the grading system order on the DEP Ed Order number 8, school year 2015. What is the DEP Ed Order number 31, school year 2020? This is an interim guidelines for assessment and grading in the light of the Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan. This is to provide the guidance on the assessment of the student learning and on the grading scheme to be adopted this school year 2020 and 2021. So on the table below, there is a basis of a grading system under the DEP Ed Order number 31, school year 2020-2021, which has a two column. In column 1, it classified into three, the written works, performance tasks, and the quarterly assessment. On the second column, there is a different subject wherein in English, Araling Panlipunan and Edukasyon sa Pagpapakatao subject, there is a written works that corresponds 40%, performance task which has the 60%. On the other hand, in science and mathematics subject, the written works has a percentage of 50% and the performance task has a percentage of 50%. On IMAPE, EPP, and TLE subjects, the written works has the percentage of 30% and the performance task has a percentage of 70%. So as you can see on the table, this is the grading system under the DEP Ed number 31 school year 2020 and 2021.
In Computation A and B, we list the DEP Ed learning areas and the contents with its weight under it. In Computation A and B, we are asked to find the grade of the three learners, which is the Learner A, Learner B, and Learner C.
To compute the grades of the learners, we will add all the score of the learners and divide to the highest possible score. And the answer we will multiply to 100 to get the PS or possible score. And to finally get the weighted average, we multiply to the corresponding or specific average. The written report is 40%, and the answer of PS we'll divide the 40%, and we make the 40% to decimal point 0.40, and that's the weighted average. And same as in the performance task, we add all the scores of the learners and get the weighted average. And the performance task and the weighted average, add them and to get the initial grade. And we have a basis from DepEd to get the final grade of the learners.